Hello, I'm LMTX, an IoT advisor and trainer. Today, I will show you how to reduce the AWS infrastructure cost for ingest of telemetry data. This is all sample scenario. We've got 100 devices. Every device sends 10 kilobytes of telemetry data every 5 seconds. I will present 3 different designs to show you how you can achieve the same outcome at totally different costs. The first design seems to be the most natural. We've got our device, which sends 10 kilobytes of data to the IoT core using this MQTT topic. DT, which stands from data, sum up telemetry. We've got IoT rule that listens for messages on this topic and stores every message to the S3 bucket. Let's review the cost aspects of this solution. First, we've got the connectivity cost. Our device needs to be constantly connected to IoT core in order to deliver telemetry data every 5 seconds. Then we've got cost of messaging, because we are using MQTT to transfer telemetry from our device to IoT core. We invoke the IoT rule to process messages and store them into S3 bucket. And we've invoked the S3 APIs in order to store messages on our target bucket. Now, let's take a deeper look about every of these cost aspects. This is the cost of connectivity. As you can see, our device is constantly connected within a month. We've got 100 devices, so we pay 35 cents for connectivity every month. This is the cost of messaging. We send 10 kilobytes of data, but the messages are built by increment of 5 kilobytes. That means that a single MQTT message of 10 kilobytes is treated as 2 billable messages. That gives us total number of messages per month times 2 billable messages times 100 devices, and we get the total number of billable messages, which end up to be $105 per month. Now, let's check the cost of the rule engine execution. Once again, we've got 10 kilobytes of data, 5 kilobytes increment, which means we pay for 2 billable messages. We execute our IoT rule for every single message, and we trigger one action. This is the action of storing data from message to the S3 bucket. That gives us $31 per month. Finally, we've got the cost of S3 bucket. It looks surprisingly high. The reason is that we invoked the API multiple times in order to store every single message as an object on our S3 bucket. So that's add up to $262 per month. This is the cost summary of our first design. We've got the IoT core cost that covers both the connectivity and messaging, and we've got the S3 cost of invoking S3 APIs to put telemetry data on the bucket. Let's move to our second design, where we improve our cost perspective a bit. In this design, we are using a basic ingest. And what basic ingest does, it reduces the cost of messaging, which is very important. But you need to be aware that whenever you're using the basic ingest, no one can subscribe to this specific topic. That means if in your case you transfer telemetry data from your message to the IoT core and you would like to receive that message from some other application or device, you cannot use basic ingest. Because when you use basic ingest, the only way to get that message is via the IoT rule. So please remember about it. Let's check details about the rule engine execution. As you can see, the total cost is exactly the same as in our previous scenario. So the monthly bill looks as follows. We've got IoT core, where we pay only for connectivity. We do not pay for messaging because we are using the basic ingest. The S3 cost is the same as in the previous design. From cost perspective, we reduced our monthly bill without any impact on required functionality. Let's go to my third design, where we reduce the total running cost even further. At the first glance, this might be counterintuitive. We want to reduce the total bill of AWS services, so why do we add yet another service to the equation? The reason is that Kinesis Data Firehose provides very important functionality for us. Using this service, we can buffer telemetry messages received by this rule before storing them to the S3 bucket. And as you remember, the cost of S3 API invocations was really high. This way, we can reduce the number of S3 API invocations and hopefully reduce the total cost. We are going to set the buffer interval for 900 seconds, so we can buffer as many telemetry messages as we can. Let's take a look at the Kinesis Firehose costs. We've got 12 messages per minute. That gives a single message every 5 seconds. Then we've got the unit multiplier, which in our case is number of devices. We've got 100 devices times number of records. That gives us total number of records. Then we multiply this value by 10 kilobytes, which is the size of a single telemetry message. Price for our Kinesis service, which is $15 per month. So we added $15 to our bill. Let's check how that impacts the S3 costs. The S3 cost looks as follows. The size of the object is way bigger than it used to be. We buffered multiple messages using Kinesis and stored them as a single object on S3 bucket. That reduced the S3 API calls, and as a reason, the monthly cost for invoking S3 APIs is just 1 cent. Just as a reminder, in our previous design, we had $262 per month. So this is a huge cost reduction. Let's check the monthly bill. The monthly bill looks as follows. The IoT Core cost is the same as in the second design. We added $15 per month for the Kinesis Firehose, but we reduced the cost of S3 APIs to a single cent per month. So when we compare that with our previous design, you can see a huge cost savings in terms of S3 APIs. So using this simple example, I showed you how you can reduce your monthly bill without any impact of the desired outcome if you understand how the AWS services work and how they are built. Let me know in case of any questions. All the best, LMTX, the IoT advisor and trainer.